Good morning, students. I am your subject teacher of history, Ms. Prabjit Kaur. It is better to be safe and protected during this pandemic disease, which you all are aware of. But in the meantime, we should not get detached from our books. So let's get started, as I'll try my level best to guide you through these learning videos. History, Standard 7, Chapter 1, Rise of Christianity. Now students, before starting this chapter, let me ask you, what is history and who is the founder of history? History is a window into the past that provides understanding of the present day and how individual, nations and global community might develop in future. Of course, what is history? History we see here, it is a window through which we go into the past. We can go and see many things which we don't know about, that we get to know in the past. That provides us understanding of the present. Now, what we are right now, that understanding we get from the past. And how an individual, nation and global community as a whole will develop in future, that also we can understand or come to know by studying history. So the next question was, who is the founder of history? The founder of history is Herodotus. Students, what do you understand by the term Christianity? Christianity is the religion that is based on the birth, life, death, resurrection and teaching of Jesus Christ. Now, you'll ask, what is resurrection? Resurrection is the act of arising from the dead and becoming alive again, which happened with Jesus Christ, and it is based on his birth, life, death and also the teachings. So we will study in this chapter everything regarding Christianity, that is birth, life, death, resurrection and the teaching and preaching everything of Jesus. So students, let us begin with the introduction of this chapter. First, look at how historians divided the study of past into periods. Among them, medieval period was also one period. What is a medieval period? Medieval period is actually that period which was between ancient and the modern period. So, what is medieval period? The period that lies between the ancient and the modern period is known as medieval period. From where did this word come from? This word came from a Latin word, medium aevum. What is the meaning of it? Medium aevum means middle age. So, whatever we are going to learn is about the middle age in history. Okay, now coming to the second point, we see it was a gradual process. Means it must be remembered that medieval period did not begin at the same time in all the parts of the world. Neither did the change from the ancient to the medieval period happen overnight. It was not the process that overnight only it started changing or something happened very suddenly. It was a very slow growing gradual process. Now, let us have a look that when the medieval period started in India. So, the medieval period in India stretched from 8th to the 18th century. I repeat, 8th to the 18th century. And after that, witnessed many changes. Now children, if it is asked that when did the medieval period in India stretch, so you will write it stretched from 8th to the 18th century. And afterwards also many changes were there. It was related to society, economy, polity, culture, then religion, many things it underwent, many changes related to that, which marked the end of the medieval period. Coming to the second last point, we see when did the medieval period start in Europe? It started in or from 6th to the 16th century CE, that is Common Era. So the medieval period in Europe stretched from 6th to the 16th century CE. So children, these both points you need to remember very carefully. Question can be asked based on these two topics. So coming to the last point, we see that this period was also called dynamic period. So the medieval period was also called dynamic period. It can be asked which period is called dynamic period. So medieval period is called dynamic period. Who called it? The historians called it. Why they called it? Because it was redefined and reorganized. Means it was organized in such a way, it was differently seen as it had many changes in it. In this slide, we'll see how did the birth of Christianity take place, or the reasons behind the birth of Christianity. So number one, the point, the Romans conquered Palestine, the homeland of the Jews. So first let us see that during the middle of the 1st century BCE, the Roman Empire was one of the greatest empire. So here they are saying about the Romans, that the Romans conquered which place? Palestine. And this Palestine was the homeland of the Jews. Jews used to reside in that place named as Palestine. After conquering the homeland of the Jews, Herod became the ruler over there. In the third point, we see people were tortured and killed by him. Herod was very harsh ruler. He used to kill Jews and torture them. Just because of this, what happened? This also made the Romans unpopular. Why? Because the Jews never used to like them. Just because of the ruler who treated them very harshly. After that we see the point, Jews no longer wanted to worship emperors as it infuriated them. Means they became angry and they no longer wanted to worship the emperors. So what did they want? In the next point we see, the Jews thus looked for the Messiah or the messenger of God, the one who will come and save their lives and from the cruel treatment of this ruler Herod. In what hope? In that hope that the Messiah would establish a kingdom of God. In the hope that the Messiah would come and liberate them from the foreign rule. Now here children, the above mentioned points were the reason why Jesus Christ preached the message of love, brotherhood and compassion. Just because of this, the birth of Christianity took place. Students, in page number 4 of your history book, you can see a picture given over here. The picture is of the remains of the castle which was believed that it was of Herod. So the here you can just see a picture, have a look at the picture. In this slide, we'll learn about the history of Jesus Christ. Jesus was born in Bethlehem, a small town near Judea, in about 4 BCE, that is before Common Era. Jesus was born where? In which place? In Bethlehem. Children, you need to learn the spelling very carefully. A small town near which place? Near Judea. J-U-D-E-A. And in the second point we see, who was Jesus? Jesus was the son of Joseph and Mary. So the spelling of Joseph and Mary you need to learn so that you don't make any mistake while writing. Okay, now third point is, an angel appeared to Mary and told her that she would give birth to a blessed child. The child was Jesus. Now what happened? When Mary was sweeping the floor one day or working in the fields, an angel appeared to Mary and she told her that very soon she will give birth to a child who will be blessed by God, and the name of the child will be Jesus. So here, children, you can also see the picture of Jesus Christ given over here. And the last point, Christ is not the surname of Jesus. Now don't think that the name Christ, which is behind Jesus, we all always write, is not his surname. But it came from the word Christos. What's the meaning of Christos? Which means God chosen one. I mean, God has chosen the one to come in this world so that he can do good to the people by preaching his message of love, brotherhood and compassion. Let us look into the life of Jesus Christ in Nazareth. Nazareth is a city in Israel with biblical history. It is this place only where the angel Gabriel told Mary that she would bear a child named Jesus. Jesus followed his father's profession. What was his father's profession? He was a carpenter. And Jesus also followed the same thing. In second point, we see that he abandoned it. Very soon, he left that profession. Now, after leaving, what did he do? After that, he began preaching the message of love, brotherhood and compassion. Now children, what do you understand by the term compassion? By compassion we mean deep awareness of the suffering of another. Or we can say having mercy or having pity on other. Students, many a time you have come across the term teaching and preaching in several subjects. Now, let us look what is the difference between the two. Preaching is proclaiming something for the things that support those sayings with scripture. Proclaiming means to announce or to disclose or to declare something. So, preaching is declaring something for the things. Suppose evidences are there, some proofs are there, some written forms are there, like scriptures. These scriptures support those sayings. So that thing, if we make the people know of, or we are reading for them, or we are saying them, that is preaching. While teaching is creating a learning environment, as we all teachers do. We create a learning environment to teach you all students. For the purpose of what? For the purpose of passing knowledge. What we are doing right now? We are passing you knowledge. So the same thing is with teaching. In this slide we learn about the preachings of Jesus Christ. Now about the life and teaching of someone, how do we know? Of course we have some past records of that person. So here in the first point we will see Our knowledge about the life and teaching comes from what? Comes from the short books. About the life history of whom? Of Jesus. Of Jesus comes from which book? From four short books named or called the Gospels. Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. Children, these terms, these words or these names you have to learn by heart. So remember, our knowledge about the life and teaching comes from four short books which are called the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. In the second point we see, Jesus preached his message in forms of parables and sermons. What are parables and what are sermons? First we will learn about parables. Parable is a short story that makes a moral or religious point. And what are sermon? Sermon is actually a religious talk. A talk on a religious or moral subject. In the third point we see that Jesus selected his followers. How many were they? They were 12 in number. So from his followers, Jesus chose 12 apostles to help them to spread the message of love and brotherhood. Now what do you mean by the term apostles? By the term apostle we mean one group which was made up of Jesus Christ's 12 original disciples. So these disciples went place to place in order to spread the message of love and brotherhood. So children, here we come to an end with the preachings of Jesus Christ. In the next class, we'll discuss on the teachings of Jesus Christ and the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. Students, you need to learn these important meanings which are given in page number 7 of your history book. So some of the words are medieval, the period that lies between the ancient and the modern period. Gospel, one of the four books of the New Testament. Parable, a short story that makes a moral or a religious point. Sermon, a talk on a religious or moral subject. Apostle, one of a group made up of Jesus Christ's 12 original disciples. Crucify, put to death by nailing or binding the hands and feet to a cross. As we see Jesus Christ. So he was crucified, means he was put to death by nailing or binding the hands and feet to a cross. Children, you need to learn these meanings by heart. The work assigned to you should be written in single lined rule classwork notebook. Answer these questions. Question 1. Which century marked the end of medieval period in Europe? Question 2. Which place did the Roman conquer in the 1st century BCE? Question 3. From where do we get to know about the life of Jesus? Write true or false. Number 1. Jews loved the Roman practice of worshipping the emperors. Number 2. Herod was popular among the Jews. Children, these are some internal question answers and true false which you need to solve, which are related to the part which I have taught you today. So, do the work in your classwork notebook. Children, this is page number 4 of your history book. So, underline all the points or all the sentences as given in this slide. Children, in this slide you'll see page number 5 of your history book. So kindly underline all the sentences which I have done in this slide.